Okay, Michael, so here is another little game for us to play. And what I want you to notice about this game before I describe it to you in detail is that we have relaxed yet another one of the constraints. So we started out playing two-player, zero-sum, deterministic games of perfect information. There was also a finite in there somewhere. From now on, we're just going to assume everything's finite because why not? And then what we did last time, just a few seconds ago, is we relaxed the deterministic part. So we had two-player, zero-sum, non-deterministic games of perfect information. And now we are going to relax the requirement for perfect information. So now we're going to look at two-player, zero-sum, possibly non-deterministic games of hidden information. And this is really important, Michael, because this last little bit of relaxation, going from perfect information to hidden information, is going to be a sort of quantum leap into the difficult problems of game theory. So this is where it starts to actually get interesting. So we've been building a foundation so far, and now we're going to get to the interesting and complicated stuff. Okay?
Wow. Yeah, I mean, one of the things that I learned just now is that the opposite of perfect is hidden.
Yes.
Like I always thought the opposite of perfect was imperfect. But, okay, so hidden, that's interesting. It's like, I guess if I don't have a perfect face, I might as well hide my face.
Right, and that's, in fact, exactly the etymology of the phrase.
All right, I understand now.
Yeah, cool. It's in Wikipedia. Okay, so here we go. Let me describe the game to you. You ready? Mm-hmm. This is a version of Minipoker, where there's a set of cards, but they have no numbers on them. There are no faces. They're just red or black, okay?
Okay.
And red is bad for our hero, player A, and black is good for our hero, player A, okay?
I see. So why does it have to be red?
I don't know, man. You know red. You know how it is. Okay, so here are the rules. They're all written down here on the screen, but let me walk through them with you. So A is dealt a card, magically. It will be red or black, and the probability of it being red or black is 50% each, okay?
Yes.
Right. So we have a uniform prior over the color. Now, remember, red is bad for A and black is good for A. So it's going to turn out, without loss of generality, that if A gets a black card, A is definitely going to hold on to the card. Okay. Now, A gets this card. B, player B, does not get to see the card. A can choose to either resign or to hold. If A resigns, given a red card, then he loses 20 cents. Okay.
Okay, wait, so A is dealt red, A may resign, but only if red.
Right.
And then A loses 20 cents.
Right.
Okay, all right.
Okay. So this is a betting game. It's not strange, it makes perfect sense. It's sort of a metaphor for life. Okay, now A can choose to hold the card, thus requiring B to do something. So if A holds the card, B can either resign or can demand to see the card. Now, if B resigns, then A gets 10 cents, regardless of the color of the card. Okay?
Yep.
Does that make sense?
Yep.
Okay. Now, if B chooses to see the card, in fact, demands to see the card, then if the card is red, then A loses 40 cents. But if the card is black, then A gets 30 cents. And since we're betting, this means that whatever A wins, B loses, and vice versa. That makes it zero sum.
Got it.
Okay. Does this all make sense?
Yeah, I don't know if I can hold all those different numbers in my head, but the basic pattern of it is that, as you say, red is bad, black is good. If A gets a bad card, A can essentially either fold, right, resign, or kind of bluff, like, hey, I've got this great card, and then if B believes that the card is bad, then and calls A or just folds, then A wins that. But if B says, no, I think maybe you're bluffing, and calls him, then everybody's rewards are more extreme, I guess.
Exactly. So it's just a version of poker. Weird version of poker, simple version of poker, but a version of poker nonetheless. There's a minor little detail here, which isn't that important, but you know, notice it's written that A may resign if it's red. Basically, A will never resign on a black card because it just doesn't make any sense. And so there's no point in writing it out. Okay? Because black is always good. Sort of nothing bad can happen to A if A gets a black card. So there's really sort of no point in writing anything out. But that's just a minor detail. Regardless, these are the rules. Okay?
Okay.
You got it?
Sure.
I'm going to redraw this as a game tree, which might make it a little bit easier for you to keep all of the rules in your head.